are these breeds? Toto? Toto! No need to be scared anymore. She ain't following us. I won't let her touch you know how. Toto! Toto! There you go! Did she hurt you?
Oh, she tried to, didn't she? She must be the meanest old woman that ever was. Let's go tell Uncle Henry and Annie M. They'll take care of her. Annie M. Annie M. Annie M.
57, 58.
Just listen what was going into Toto. Is she?
Dorothy, please, we're trying to count.
Oh, but Aunt M, she isn't.
Please don't bother us right now, honey. This old egg incubator's gone bad, and we're likely to lose a lot of our chicks.
Oh, the poor little things. Oh, and Aunt M, this goat hit Toto over the back with a rake just because she says he gets in her garden and chases her an ass heel cat every day.
Dorothy, please!
But he doesn't do it every day. Just once or twice a week. And he can't catch her old cat anyway. And now she says she's
70. Dorothy! We're busy.
Uncle Henry, can't you do something?
I'm doing something right now, honey, to stay out of our hair.
All right.
Oh, who was the genius suggested we move the wagon before the wheel was on?
Well, it wasn't so heavy with one less wheel. Wait, that makes sense, right?
Well, sense or no sense, when I lift up the axle, you two shove her on.
Zeke, Hickory, won't this go sit to Toto?
I swear they made this new wheel smaller than the other three.
She tried to kill him.
Oh, bigger or smaller, put her on for my arms or 'twill clean out their sockets. I ain't a statue, you know. I ain't made of iron.
Okay, okay.
Why won't anyone listen to me? Don't care about Toto.
No! Oh! Got my finger!
What am I going to do about Miss Goldchunk? Just because Toto tastes her old cat.
Oh, look at Dorothy. You're not using your head about Miss Gulch. Ain't you got no brains?
Sure I have brains.
Well, then why don't you use them? The next time you come home, don't go by Miss Gulch's place. Toto won't get in the garden. Won't get in that car. See?
Quit just standing there! Clear the junk out of that wagon! We got a parcel of lumber to haul from town before the weather turns!
Will do, Mr. Gale.
Zeke, what am I going to do?
Well, for a start, kid, don't let that old Gulch ever try to buffalo you. She ain't nothing to be afraid of. You gotta stand up to her, that's all. With a little courage, a little grit.
I'm not afraid of her.
That's what I wanted to hear. Walk with your head up, your chest out. And the next time she squawks, you just stroll right up to her and spit in her eye. What would I do?
Would you really?
Sure I would. Through this life, you gotta walk tall, shoot straight. Then you got no reason to be a scared and nothing to nobody.
Are you alright?
What are you trying to do, silly guy?
Don't be so cruel.
It was just a rib, Dorothy.
Can't you see how white he is? You really scared him.
Who was scared?
You were scared. If you were a jackrabbit, you'd be in the other county by now.
Here, here. What's all the chopper hopping when there's work to be done? I know three shipless farmhands will be out of the job before they know.
Well, we was just having a little fun, Mrs. Gale.
A farm's no place for fun. You want fun? Go join a circus.
Might just do that. Be a strong man. See the world.
Well, don't start posing for it now. Here, here. Can't work on the neck of stomach. Have some things.
Oh, gosh, Mrs. Gale.
Just wait.
Oh, well.
Well, you don't have to sit down to eat them. Get that wagon hitched up, and Zeke, you'll feed those hogs before they worry themselves and me.
Yes, ma'am.
And yeah. Really? Do you know Miss Goat said she was going to do to Toto?
Dorothy, dear, stop imagining things. You always get yourself into a fret over nothing.
Well, I'm just...
Now, can you just help us out today and find yourself a place where you won't get into any trouble?
Some place where there isn't any trouble. I wonder if there is such a place, Toto. It's not a place you can get to by a boat or a train. It's a place far, far away. Beyond the moon, behind the rain. When all the world is a homeless jungle and the raindrops tumble all around, heaven opens a magic lane. When all the clouds darken up the sky.
Being a Christian.
Christian woman.
I can't say it.
Well, I can. So if you don't want to hear it, you better peddle your carcass off my land.
I don't take kindly to that kind of talk. Henry, just remember, I have friends in high places.
And why don't you climb on your broomstick and go visit them? You get the wheel on that wagon yet?
Nearly done, Mr. Gale.
Nearly ain't good enough. You get it done right now. Sky's getting darker every minute.
Come inside, honey.
No. I'm not going anywhere with you. If you really loved me, you wouldn't have let Toto go.
She had an order from a sheriff, Dorothy. What did you expect us to do? Wave a wand and make it disappear?
We still could have tried, at least. You just stood there like you stuffed or something.
Well, I just couldn't think of anything to say. I'm sorry.
One mean old woman, and you were afraid of her.
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you were worst of all. You stopped Toto from getting away. I just hate you!
Oh, don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel all terrible inside. My heart's been all tore out.
I don't care. I never want to see any of you again. Ever, ever, ever. Toto's the only friend I had in the world. Now I have no one to play with, no one to talk to. I'll never see him again for as long as I live. Toto? Toto! Oh, Toto, darling, you came back! Oh, you got away from the horrible old woman, you wonderful dog. But she'll be coming back for you any minute. We have to get away. We have to run away. We need food for me and a bone for you. Then we're getting far, far away from here. We're never, ever coming back.
Here, doggy.
Where is that dreaded animal?
Here, doggy, come on now.
I asked you to get off of my land, Miss Gulch.
I did, but the dog got away.
He can't even enjoy your company much.
Where the little girl is, that's where I'll find the dog. Kindly bring her out here.
You never give up, do you? Dorothy!
She ain't in the house, Henry. The fresh batch of cookies is missing. My picture from the mantel, that's gone too.
Sounds like you throw it away in your hands.
If she's out on the road, I'll find her. And then I'll take that dog back for good.
You're so anxious to have it, then you should have looked after it better.
Oh, don't blame me. The cat from the basket was faulty. That's the last time I buy anything from a charity bazaar.
Equally, on both sides. Well, house guests. And who might you be? Now, don't tell me. You're traveling in disguise. No, that's not right. You're going on a visit. No, I'm wrong. You're running away.
How did you guess?
Professor Marvel never guesses. He knows! Now, why are you running away?
Why?
No, don't tell them. They don't understand you at home. They don't appreciate you. You want to see other lands. Big cities, big mountains, and big oceans.
It's just like you can read both sides of me.
Well, it is my training. My calling. Oh, see what it says inside of my conveyance.
Oh, Toto, that's not polite. We haven't been asked yet.
Oh, he's perfectly welcome. As one dog to another, huh? where were we?
Oh, please, Professor. Why can't we go with you to see all the crown heads of Europe?
You know any? Oh, the thing. Well, I never do anything without consulting my crystal. Oh, here, sit right here. Now, just make yourself comfortable while I... Why conjure out of the air, out of thin air. Now, this very genuine, magic, authentic crystal was used by the priests of the Isis and Osiris in the days of the pharaohs of Egypt, in which Cleopatra foresaw the approach of Julius Caesar and Mark Antony and so on and so on. Now, you better hold out your hand, my child, in order to look into the future. Now, you'd better close your eyes in order to be better in tune with the infinite. Oh, we can't do these things without reaching out into the infinite. Yes, that's very good. You can open them now. You'll gaze into the crystal. Oh, what's this I see? It's a house with a picket fence.
That's our farm.
Yes. And there's a woman. She's wearing a polka dot dress, and her face is careworn.
That's Annie M.
Yes.
What's she doing?
Well, I can't quite see. Oh, she's crying. Oh, someone has just about broken her heart.
Why would anyone do that?
I don't know. Someone she loves very much. Someone she's been very kind to. Someone she's taken care of in sickness.
I had the measles once. She stayed right by my side every second. But that's when I was very young. She doesn't care about me at all now, and I don't care about her.
Oh. Well, that's not what the crystal says.
They were going to kill Toto, and she did nothing to stop them.
I don't see any of that in the crystal. All I see is a woman who does the best she can, and misses you something terrible.
What's she doing now?
Oh, she has her hand on her heart. Oh, she's falling down on the bed.
You don't suppose she could really be sick, do you? I have to get to her right away.
Oh, what's this? I thought you were coming along with me.
Oh, no, I really have to get to her. Goodbye, Professor. Thanks a lot.
Goodbye. Safe travels. Oh, better get the wagon undercover. There's a storm blowing. Oh, Whopper! Oh, poor kid. Oh, I hope she gets home safe.
Yeah! bad witch.
Who?
Me?
Oh, I'm not a witch at all. I'm Dorothy Gale from Kansas.
Oh, well, is that a witch?
Who, Toto? Oh, Toto's my dog.
Well, I'm a little muddled. The Munchkins called me because a new witch has dropped a house on the Big Witch of the East, and there's the house, and here you are, and those legs. Are all that's left of the Wicked Witch of the East. And so, what the Munchkins would like to know is, are you a good witch or a bad witch?
But I've already told you, I'm not a witch. What's your shirt?
Golden. Ugly. What was that? The Munchkins, they're laughing because I'm a witch. I'm Glinda, Witch of the North.
You are? I beg your pardon, but I've never heard of a beautiful witch before.
Only bad witches are ugly.
If you please, what are Munchkins?
The little people who live in this land, and blue is their favorite color. This is Munchkin Land, and you are their national heron, my dear. It's all right. You can come out. It's all right. You can come out and thank her. It's all right.
Come out, wherever you are, and meet the young lady who fell from a star. She fell from the sky, she fell very far, and Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
She fell out of Kansas, a miracle occurred.
It really was no miracle. What happened was just this. The wind began to switch, the house to pitch, and suddenly the ninja started to unhitch. Just then, a witch to satisfy an itch was flying on her broomstick, thumbing for a hitch.
And oh, what happened then was great.
The house began to pitch, the kitchen took a search, it landed on the wing and went to the middle of the ditch. Which was not a healthy situation for a wicked witch. The house began to pitch, the kitchen took a search, it landed on the wing and went to the middle of the ditch. Which was not a healthy situation for a wicked witch. Two began to twitch, and was reduced to just a stitch. A lord was born of so wicked.
Thank you very sweetly.
And now that the joyous news be spread, the wicked old witch at last is dead!
If she is morally, ethically,
spiritually, physically,
positively, absolutely,
Undeniably and reliably dead.
For all the Munchkins and their descendants,
if any.
Let the joyous news be spread. The wicked old witch at last is dead!
Ding dong, the witch is dead. Witch, oh witch, the wicked witch. Ding dong, the wicked witch is dead. Wake up, you sleepy head. Rub your eyes, get out of bed.
Be gone before someone drops a house on you, too!
bide my time. And as for you, my fine lady, it's true I can't attend to you here and now as I like, but after a suitable period of mourning,
I shall have those slippers and my revenge too!
So let's try to stay out of my way.
Just try!
I'll get you eventually, my pretty.
And your little dog too!
Just slip off.
I'll certainly try.
It's an awful stiff nail.
Whoa! 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 There goes some of me again.
Does it hurt you?
Oh, no, no. I just keep picking it up and putting it back in.
Here, let me help you.
Oh, my. It is good to be free. Whoa! Well, did I scare you?
No, I just thought you might have hurt yourself.
But I didn't scare you.
No, of course not.
I didn't think so. You see, I can't even scare a crow.
Howdy, neighbor.
They come from miles around just to eat my fields.
Howdy, scarecrow.
I'd laugh in my face. Said a scarecrow swinging on a pole to a black bird sitting on a fence. Oh, the Lord gave me a soul, but forgot to give me common sense.
Said the black bird, well,
what
is that there
to do with common sense? Said the scarecrow, 'twould be pleasing just to reason out the reason for the witches and the whiners and the wench. If I had an ounce of common sense, I could watch the hours, confirm the flowers, consoles it with the rain. And my head I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain. I'd unravel any riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain.
With the thoughts you'll be thinking, you could be another Lincoln.
If I only had a brain. Oh, I can tell you why.
You could think of things you've never thought before.
And then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nothing. My head all full of stuffing. My heart all full of pain. I would dance and be merry, life would be a dignitary if I only had a brain. Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I've never thought before.
And then he'd sit and think some more.
Gosh, it would be awful pleasing to reason out the reason for things I can't explain. Then perhaps I deserve ya, or be even worthy of ya, if I only had a brain. If I only had a brain.
That was wonderful. If our scarecrows back in Kansas could do that, the crows would be scared to pieces.
They would?
Oh, yes.
Where is this? Kansas.
That's where I live. I want to get back there so badly. I'm going all the way to the Emerald City to get the Wizard of Oz to help me.
You're going to see the wizard?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, do you think if I came with you, this wizard could get me some brains?
I couldn't say. But even if he didn't, we'd be no worse off than you are now.
That is true.
But maybe you better not. I have a witch about me, you might get yourself into trouble.
A witch? I'm not afraid of no witch. I'm not afraid of anything. Except for maybe a lighted match.
I don't blame you for that.
Oh, but I would face a whole box full of them in a chance to get me some brains. Oh, won't you take me with you? Because I won't be any problems. Well, because I don't need anything. And, well, I won't try and manage anything because I don't have a brain. Just take me with you.
Of course I will.
All right! I'm going to go get me some brains.
Yippee! Woo! You're not starting off very well.
Oh, I'll try. Really, I will.
To Oz?
To Oz.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. Here he is, a wizard, a wizard, if ever a wizard was. If ever, ever a wizard was, the Wizard of Oz is one.
Because, 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 because.
anyway.
How's that?
Too much of a stuffed shirt.
About me, as long as I keep my legs well stuffed, I can walk to the Emerald City no matter what shape I am in on top.
It's a very kind offer, but I don't eat hay.
Oh. Well, then perhaps it's for the better. A little mother field mouse has made a nest in here, and I don't think she'd like to be disturbed. Ooh, hi.
Oh, look, Scarecrow. Apples.
Apples? What are apples?
In the trees.
You mean those little red birds hanging upside down from one leg?
They're not birds. They're something you eat, and they're delicious. Ouch!
You think you're doing?
We were walking a long way, and I was hungry. Did you say something?
She was hungry? She was hungry. How would you like it if somebody came along and picked something off of you?
I'm sorry. I keep forgetting I'm not in Kansas anymore.
Well, come along, Dorothy. You don't want any of those apples. Yuck!
Are you hinting that my apples aren't what they ought to be?
Oh, no. I'm just saying that she doesn't like apples with little green worms in them.
Worms? Did he say we had worms? That's what it sounded like to me!
I'll show you how to get some apples. Sure, you got worms! Worms, caterpillars, and probably a whole bunch of wood lice, too.
How dare you! Let's give it to girls! Take that! How do you like them apples?
We like them just fine, thank you!
I've suddenly twigged. So have I. They've made sense of us all!
I think it's time we bowed out. Made out of tin.
Oh.
Look. Did you say something?
Oil can.
He said oil can.
Oil can what?
Oil can. Here it is. Where would you like to be oiled first?
No.
He set his mouth.
My goodness, I can talk again. Oh, please, oil my arms, oil my elbows. Oh.
Did that hurt?
Oh, no, it feels wonderful. I've held that axe up for ages.
How did you ever get like this?
Well, when I was flesh and blood like you, I fell in love with a munchkin maiden whose mother hated me. So to stop me from marrying her daughter, she hired the Wicked Witch of the West to put an evil spell on my axe. When I went to chop down a tree, I chopped off my leg instead.
Mm. It chopped off your leg?
That's terrible.
But by good fortune, I knew of a wonderful tinsmith who made me a new leg almost as good as the old one. So back I went to work. And you know what happened?
Something terrible, I bet.
When I went to swing the axe, dang me if I didn't take out the other one.
You should have gotten a new axe.
I guess you're right. But I got me a new leg instead. And back I went to work. This time I chopped off both my arms.
Well, I see how you could have managed to chop off one arm. But how did you manage to chop off both?
I told you, the axe was enchanted.
You see, Dorothy, if I had a brain, I could figure that out for myself.
I sometimes wish I hadn't gotten myself a new pair of arms from the tinsmith, because the last time I swung the axe was the worst time of all.
Yeah, I don't want to hear this, thank you.
What happened?
I split myself right down the middle.
Oh, you poor thing.
So I had the tinsmith make me a new head and body. But on the way home, I got caught in a terrible rainstorm and rusted solid.
It just wasn't your day, was it?
I've been here ever since.
Well, you're perfect now.
Oh, my neck. Oh, perfect. Just bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Go ahead, bang on it.
Oh, that's a beautiful echo.
It's empty. The tinsmith forgot to give me a heart.
No heart.
No heart. All hollow. And without a heart, I can never love my munchkin maiden.
Oh, don't cry, Tin Man. You'll rust again.
I used to carve a name in every tree.
You can say that again.
Said a tin man around a tree is dead. To a strong man, sad and weary eye.
Oh, the smith gave me two ribs, but forgot to put a heart inside. When a man's an empty kettle, he should be on his mettle, and yet I'm torn apart. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kinda human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and awful sentimental regarding love and art. I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy that shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Picture me a balcony above, a voice sings low.
Where art thou, Romeo?
I hear a beat.
How sweet.
Just to register emotion, jealousy, devotion, and really feel a part. I would stay young and chipper, and I'd lock it with a zipper if I only had a heart.
My axe.
Certainly chopped you down to size, didn't it? And now you're helping the little lady along, are you, my fine gentleman?
Well, stay away from her!
Or I'll stuff a mattress with you, Scarecrow. And you, Superman. I'll use you for a beehive.
I'm not afraid of you.
That just proves you don't have a brain. Allow me to educate you. Here, Scarecrow. Want to play ball?
Oh, fire! Oh, please!
Just remember, helping that girl reach the Emerald City could be your last burning ambition!
I'm still not afraid of her. Don't worry, Dorothy. I'll make sure you get to the Emerald City whether I get a brain or not. Stuff a mattress with me.
I'll see you reach the wizard whether I get a heart or not. Beehive, bah! Let her try and make a beehive out of me.
Oh, you're the best friends anybody ever had. And it's funny, but I feel as if I've known you all the time. But I couldn't have, could I?
Well, I don't see how. You weren't around when I was stuffed and sewn together, were you?
I was here rusting for the longest time.
It really doesn't matter. We know each other now, don't we?
That's right.
We do.
Look, to Oz.
To Oz.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard of a wiz, if ever a wiz there was. If ever a wizard of a wiz there was, the wizard of Oz is one
because.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz.
They're branching out to the wild forest. I wouldn't be seen dead in that wild forest.
If I grew there, I'd be petrified.
Darker before it gets lighter.
Do you suppose we meet any wild animals while we're out here?
We might.
Wild animals that speak straw?
Some, but mostly lions and tigers and bears.
Oh, lions.
Tigers?
And bears.
Oh my. Lions, tigers, and bears. Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears. Which one of you first? I'll fight you both together if you want. I'll fight you with one paw tied behind my back. I'll fight you standing on one foot. I'll fight you with my eyes closed. Pulling an axe on me, eh? Sneaking up on me, eh? Why?
Here. Go away and leave us alone.
Oh, scared, huh? Afraid, huh? How long can you stay fresh in that can? Come on, get up and fight, you shivering junkyard. Put your hands up, you lopsided bag of hay.
Oh, that's getting personal on it!
Woof.
No!
Yes, why don't you get up and teach him a lesson?
Well, what's wrong with you teaching him a lesson?
Well, I hardly know him.
Well, I'll pick you anyway, Pee-wee.
Oh, shame on you!
What'd you do that for? I didn't bite him.
No, but you try to. It's bad enough picking up straw man. Won't you go picking up poor little dogs?
Well, you didn't have to go and hit me, did ya? Is my nose bleeding?
No, of course not. My goodness, what a fuss you're making. Naturally, when you go around picking on things weaker than you are, why, you're nothing but a great big coward.
Oh, right, I am a coward. I haven't got any courage at all. I even scare myself. Look at the circles under my eyes. I haven't slept in weeks.
Have you tried counting sheep?
That doesn't do any good. I'm afraid of him.
Well, that's too bad. Why don't you come along with us? We're going to see the Wizard of Oz to get him a heart.
And him a brain.
I'm sure he can give you some courage.
Well, wouldn't you feel degraded to be seen in the company of a cowardly lion? I would.
Oh, of course not.
Jade, that's awfully nice of you. My life has been simply unbearable. Even my family's disowned me. When I was a little cub, my father took me to the top of a high mountain, waved his paw around and said, "One day, son, all this will be yours." Oh, I was terrified.
Why is that?
I'm scared of heights.
Oh, right, the wizard reflects everything.
At least you'll be safe if I come with you.
How's that?
No self-respecting wild animal will come anywhere near me. Set a lion. Poor neurotic lion. To a miss. Listen to him rave. Oh, the Lord made me a lion, but the Lord forgot to make me brave. Then his tail began to curl and wave. Life is sad, believe me, Missy, when you're born to be a sissy without the dimming void. But I could change my habits, never more be scared of rabbits if I only had the noise. I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, a fate I don't deserve. But I could show my prowess, be a lion, not a mouse, if I only had the noise.
Oh, you be in your stride, a king down to the core.
I could show the dinosaurus who's king around the forest, a king they fed a soy. Why, with my regal beezer, I could be another Caesar if I only had the noise. I'd be brave as a blizzard.
I'd be gentle as a lizard.
I'd be clever as a gizzard.
If the blizzard is a wizard who will serve,
then I'm sure to get a brain,
a heart,
a home,
the noise.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard, a wiz, if ever a wiz there was. If ever, ever a wiz there was, the Wizard of Oz is one. Because of the wonderful things he does. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
Like the interfering bugs they are. Shall I be witty and creative? The bug alternative is attractive, but messy. So witty and creative wins the day. Something with poison in it, I think. With poison in it, but attractive to the eye and soothing to the smell. Poppies? Poppies? Poppies!
Flower.
It smells so wonderful. And the singing
too. It sounds just like the heavenly semaphores.
I can't walk anymore. I'm so sleepy.
Oh, give us your hand, we'll pull you along.
No, I'll have to rest for just a minute. You lay there, Joe. We'll have a little sleep together.
We've got to go on.
Come to think of it, 40 winks wouldn't be a bad idea.
Oh, it's the harpies. That's what's doing it. Oh, it's the Wicked Witch. Nobody's gonna hear you! Fine. Help! Somebody please help me! I don't know what to do!
I hear you, Scarecrow! And although I can't undo the magic of the Wicked Witch of the West, perhaps a little magic of my own will save the day.
shoulders are high. Giddy just looking at them.
Oh, ring the bell, Scarecrow. Let them know we're here.
Well, here goes nothing.
Oh, rang that bell?
Don't do that.
We did.
Can't you read?
Read what?
A notice.
What notice?
It's on the door. It's as plain as the nose on my face. Just a moment.
Bell out of order, please.
Well, then that's more like it. Now, state your business.
We want to see the wizard.
The wizard, but nobody can see the wizard. Nobody's ever seen the Great Oz. Even I've never seen him.
Well, and how do you know there even is one?
Well, if there wasn't a wizard, then why would you all be here?
Well, please, sir, we have to get to the wizard right away. The good witch of the North sent me.
Prove it.
She's wearing the ruby slippers that she gave her.
So she is. Well, bust my buttons. Why didn't you say that in the first place? That's a different color.
Who's he calling horse? Why, if he weren't on the other side of that door,
he's coming out.
He'd be on this side.
Welcome to the Emerald City. Welcome.
Thank you.
Have you come far?
Just the longest of ways.
Believe me, every step of the way is worth it. Have you just any idea how wonderful this place truly is?
I've been trying to imagine it, but I haven't got a brain.
They said I'd fall in love with it. If I had a heart,
it's the one place I don't need any courage, because there's nothing to scare me, is there?
There's a garden spot, I'm told, where it's never too hot, and it's never too cold.
Never too young, and never too old,
and you're never too thin or tall.
And you're never, never, never too anything at all.
It's all true! Oh, we're not too mad, and we're not too sane, and we don't compare, and we don't complain. All we do is just sit tight, 'cause it's also so downright right. Hurry, hurry, hurry!
And a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we got the day away in the merry old land of Oz. Buzz, 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 chirp, 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 and a couple of la-dee-da's. That's how the crickets crick all day in the merry old land of Oz. We get up at 12 and start to work at 1. Take an hour for lunch, and then at 2 we're done.
Jolly good fun!
Ha ha ha, ho ho ho, and a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away in the merry old land of Oz. Ha ha ha,
ho ho ho, and a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away with a ha ha ha, ha ha ha, the merry old land of Oz.
Everything you said was, and more.
When do we get to see the wizard? Will you take us to him?
Is he scary?
The wizard, of course! But first off, take you to a place where you can tidy up a bit.
Thank you.
they were brass. That's how we can do it in Fairyland of Oz.
Certain air of savoir faire in the merry old land of Oz.
Ha ha ha, ho ho ho.
Ho 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 ho.
That's how we got the day away in the merry old land of Oz.
We get up at 12 and start some work at 1. Taking off for lunch and then 2 are done.
Jolly fun! Ha ha ha, ho ho ho.
A king.
hold.
You dare come to me for a heart, do you? Your clinking, clacking, clattering collection. A collection is junk.
Yes, sir. Your Honor, you see, a while back we were traveling down the Yellow
And you, scarecrow, have the effrontery to ask for a brave you billowing bear of all my bark.
Yes, Your Majesty. Your Honor, do you wish a drink?
And you, lion? Well!
Oh, you ought to be ashamed of yourself, frightening him like that. He came to you for help.
Say that it was supper! The beneficent Oz has every intention of granting your request.
What's that? What did he say?
Are you all right?
Just a little deaf. What did he say?
He's going to help us after all.
He is.
But first, you must prove yourself worthy by performing a very small task.
A small task? Is that all?
You name it, it's half done.
Bring me the broomstick of the Witch of the West.
Lion!
What if we do that? We'd have to kill her.
Bring me her broomstick, and I'll grant your request. Now go.
But what if she kills us first?
I said, go!
Don't worry, I'm already gone.
Given up this crazy scheme. I never should have let you see the wizard.
I'm glad you did. How else can I get back to Kansas?
Yeah, you don't have to worry about us.
We won't be going after the witch empty-handed.
You can... Say that again.
Now, which way to her castle?
No one knows for sure. No one's ever been there?
Oh, yes, plenty of folks have gone there, but no one's ever come back.
Oh, boy.
There's no yellow brick road to follow now.
There's no road at all in the land of the Winkies.
Winkies? What's Winkies?
Once they were people very much like us, then the Wicked Witch made them her slaves. I hope the same thing doesn't happen to you.
So do I.
Keep going west where the sun sets.
Is that the best way to find the Wicked Witch?
You won't have to find her, Dorothy. When she knows you're in the land of the Winkies, she'll find you. Good luck!
Sometimes, it's a good thing not to have a brain. Because I haven't the wit to be scared.
And I haven't the heart to fail.
And I haven't said goodbye to the wizard.
Oh, how can you desert Dorothy now?
Well, I could stay here. That's one way of doing it.
You're more of a coward than I thought. Shame on you.
Well, it's easy for you to speak. You're made of straw, and you're made of tin. But I am only weak flesh.
Very weak.
Verging on flabby.
It's all right, Lion. You can stay here if you'd like.
I'd like. Oh, how I'd like. But if you really need me, I'll... tag along, I guess.
Oh, good man.
A stout fellow.
Oh, ready to go, Dorothy?
Best foot forward.
Best foot.
Come on, Lion.
Oh, I'm coming. The Scarecrow's not the only one who needs a new brain.
Baggage onto my territory. How to bring her here before? Winkies? Winkies, come!
fine job we did of protecting Dorothy.
Oh, help, help. What happened to you?
Well, they tore my legs off. They threw them over there. And they took my arm off. They threw it over there.
You scarecrow, that's you all over.
Time you pulled yourself together.
Well, I'd like to, but I can't reach my legs.
I'll get them.
Then we'll go find Dorothy.
That is right, Tin Man. Ooh. And the lion will lead us.
Yeah, me?
Yes, you.
I'm going to lead us against the forces of evil.
That's right.
All right. I'll do it for Dorothy. Wicked witch or no wicked witch. Guards or no guards. I'll tear him apart. Ruff, ruff. I may not come out of it alive, but I'll go down a fighting. Ruff. There's only one thing I want you fellas to do.
What's that?
Talk me out of it.
Which one Dorothy's in?
It's Toto!
Oh,
Toto!
Oh, Toto! Here, Toto!
Oh, he'll lead us to Dorothy!
But we still have to get inside the castle.
Do you think it'll be polite dropping in like this? Who's there? Fine. He's got a plan.
It might not work.
It might not work.
But it's got a chance.
It's got a chance.
Only thing is, it's very, very dangerous. What do you say?
I say, anyone else got a plan?
Let's hear the scarecrows.
Well, first, we need to get our hands on the 3 wiki uniforms.
Fellas? 3 wiki uniforms? Where are we gonna find 3 winky uniforms?
Fellas!
I don't know, but the whole plan depends upon it.
3 winky uniforms.
Fellas, we don't have to look far.
How come?
They're right behind us!
She's dead. You killed her.
I didn't mean to kill her, really. It's just that she was going to set him on fire.
Hail to Dorothy! The Wicked Witch is dead!
Hail to Dorothy! The Wicked Witch is dead!
You are now our queen.
That's very kind of you, but I must get back to Kansas. The witch's broom? May we have it?
Oh, yes, please, of course. Take it with you.
Thank you. Now we can go back to the wizard and tell him the Wicked Witch is dead!
The Wicked Witch is dead!
Ding-dong, the witch is dead, witch, oh witch, the Wicked Witch. Ding-dong, the Wicked Witch is dead. He's golden, golden, so beloved, beloved, your bow. Let's open up and sing, and ring the bells out. Ding-dong, very low, sing it hearty, sing it low. Let them know the Wicked Witch is.
Than you have, but they have one thing you haven't got, a medal. Therefore, in consideration of conspicuous bravery, fantastic valor, and meritorious conduct, I award you the Purple Cross. You are now a member of the Legion of Courage.
Oh, shucks, folks. I'm speechless.
Oh, as for you, my galvanized friend, you want a heart. You have no idea how lucky you are not to have one. Hearts will never be practical until they can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Well, back where I come from, we have men who do nothing all day but good deeds. They are called good deed doers. And they have no more heart than you have. But they have one thing you haven't got. A testimonial. Therefore, in consideration of your kindness, I take pleasure at this time in presenting you with a gift of our esteem and affection. And remember, my sentimental friend, that a heart is not judged by how much you love, but by how much you are loved by others.
Oh, it ticks! Oh, look, I listen to my heart, it ticks!
Read what my medal says.
Awarded for courage.
Ain't it the truth? Ain't it the truth?
They're all so wonderful.
Well, hey! Come back! Well, what about Dorothy?
Yes, what about Dorothy?
Yeah!
Oh, yes,
Dorothy, next!
I don't think there's anything in there for me.
You forced me into a very cataclysmic decision. The only way to get Dorothy back to Kansas is for me to take her there myself.
Oh, will you? Could you? Are you a clever enough wizard to manage that?
Child, you cut me to the quick. I'm an old Kansas man myself. Balloonist per excellence to the Miracle Wonderland Carnival Company, while one day performing fantastic feats of stratospheric skill, never before seen by civilized man, my balloon failed to return to the fair.
It did?
Frightened, were you?
Frightened? You are looking at a man who has laughed in the face of danger, sneered at doom, and chuckled at catastrophe. I was petrified. Then, suddenly, the wind changed, and my balloon floated down to the heart of this noble city, where I instantly acclaimed Oz, the first wizard deluxe.
Deluxe? It's just from the French, pertaining to luxury.
Well, there were a few luxuries came with the job, but I took it anyway. And in the advent of a quick getaway, the balloon is ready for departure. And in that conveyance, my dear Dorothy, you and I shall return to the land of E Pluribus Unum. Oh, come, come. Gather. About to embark on a hazardous and technically unexplainable journey into the outer stratosphere to converse, and otherwise hobnob with my brother wizards. I hereby decree that until that time, if any, that I shall return. The Scarecrow, by virtue of his superior brain, shall rule in my stead, assisted by the Tin Man, by virtue of his magnificent heart, and the Lion by virtue of his courage. Obey them as you would me. Thank you, friends! And now we'd better be getting on. Oh, climb aboard, Dorothy, climb aboard.
Climb aboard, Missy, while the wind's in your favor.
Where's Judo? I can't leave without him.
Don't worry, I'll get him for you.
Oh, don't let go of the rope!
What?
Oh, this is highly irregular.
The balloon's going up.
Oh.
Professor, you can't leave.
Oh, this is unprecedented.
Here's your dog.
Please, Professor, you have to come back.
Oh, I can't. I don't know how it works. Goodbye, everyone.
Idiot god, ruin my exit. stay with us, Dorothy?
We don't want you to leave.
Don't you love us?
No, I do. There's a place, people that I love more. And now, out farther away from the furthest dream. Scarecrow, I'll never see Kansas again for as long as I live. Never, ever, never.
Never is a very long time, Dorothy.
Oh, please, please, will you help me?
You don't need to be helped any longer. You always have the power to go back to Kansas.
I have?
Well, then why didn't you tell her sooner?
Because she wouldn't have believed me. She had to learn for herself.
Well, what have you learned, Dorothy?
Well, I think that it's not enough for me to want to see Uncle Henry and Annie Ann. That it's... If I ever go looking for my heart's desire ever again, it's no longer any farther than my own backyard. Because if it isn't there, I never really lost it to begin with. Is that right?
That's all it is.
But that's so easy. I should have thought of that for you.
I should have felt it in my heart.
Me too, if I had the courage of my convictions.
No, she had to find it out for herself. Now those ruby slippers will take you home in 2 seconds.
Toto 2?
Toto 2.
Oh, it would be so hard to say goodbye. I love you all so much. Goodbye, Tin Man. Don't cry. You're rushed again. Goodbye.
Goodbye. No wonder I have a heart. Oh, 'cause it's breaking.
Goodbye, Lion. I know it isn't right. And I'm gonna miss the way you used to holler for hope before you found your courage.
When you go, I think I'm gonna do a little more hollering.
Dear Scarecrow, you were my first friend here. I think maybe I'll miss you most of all.
Having a brain, it doesn't make parting any easier, Dorothy. Goodbye. Catch you always.
Are you ready now?
Yes. Please. Before I stay forever.
Then tap your heels 3 times and close your eyes and think to yourself over and over, there's no place like home. There's no place like home.
No place like home.
1.
There's no place like home.
2.
There's no place like home.
Notify the sheriff.
Wait.
Toto? Oh, over there! Dorothy. Dorothy?
Oh, she's over here. Tell Abby and bid her bring a blanket.
Oh! Oh, she's got a lump on her head the size of an ostrich egg. Oh, all but the skin ain't broken.
Hello, Oz.
Oz? My name is Chester. But you can call me whatever you'd like.
Uncle Henry, you're the guard.
I'm guarding you now, honey. I'll see you come to no more harm.
Is she all right?
There was a minute there when I thought she'd left us.
But I did leave you, Uncle Henry. That's just the trouble. I tried to get back for days and days.
Sounds like a bad dream.
It wasn't a dream.
Sure it wasn't. Remember me? It's your old pal Zeke.
Lion.
Oh, it ain't. This here's Hickory.
You couldn't forget my face, could you?
No, of course not. But where's Scarecrow?
Scarecrow? Who the heck's Scarecrow?
Here's the blanket you called for.
You lost all your stuffing.
Stuffing?
What'll happen to the field mouse you had in your stomach?
Field mouse? You can't be more like a sack of kittens in my heart.
Dorothy? Minion! Oh, you're safe and well. Thanks to you, Minion. You taught me how to use the slippers.
I won't use the slipper on you, honey. You haven't done anything wrong.
No. You don't understand. This was a true, truly live place. You were all there. You kept rushing up, and you kept pulling your own tail. And you were a humbug.
Well, let's not get personal.
Does anyone believe me?
Of course we believe you, honey. Now let's get you into bed.
Has the house come back? It's telling the Wicked Witchy now.
Storm passed right by it.
It wasn't a house fell on Miss Gulch.
It was a telegraph pole.
We won't be hearing from that old biddy till her legs get out of plaster.
The Toto's safe. You read that, Toto? We're both safe. And we're going home. Home. And we're never, ever gonna leave here ever again. Because I love you all so much. Oh, Indiana, there really is no place like home.